Alright, so hello and welcome back, guys. Today I did a couple of things off screen, but not really, like, it wasn't planned, it was an accident, because I fucked up by not recording with Audacity. Shit like that still happens to me every now and then, even though I've been doing YouTube for quite a while now. So yeah, I lost like 30 minutes. I recorded it, but I didn't have the Audacity recording, so it's not something I'm gonna be uploading in a playthrough. However, I will go ahead and pause this episode and show you the perforator fight, because I went ahead and fought the perforators. After that, or like before that, I farmed the aerospec armor, and then after that they built a couple of NPC houses. So yeah, we should be getting the alchemist NPC soon, so I can actually prepare for skeleton. Because my plan for today's episode is to take on skeleton next, to completely skip Old One's army and Queen Bee, because I just want to go and visit the Abyss as soon as possible. The Abyss version came out a couple of hours ago, or when you see this video it should be like almost a day ago. So it's pretty amazing, and finally it's public on the TMod loader so everyone can get it. And to celebrate it, I want to visit the Abyss as soon as possible, because I no longer have to worry about accidentally spoiling anything. So yeah, my goal is to just skip to Skeleton, kill him, get the Shadow Key? Yeah, Shadow Key from the dungeon, and then go right ahead and take the Abyss on, which I really want, like really badly want to show off. So yeah, here we go. Let's go and buy some potions, and then I'm gonna prepare for Skeleton, which shouldn't be too hard. Oh yeah, and before I forget it, I'm gonna go and show the perforator fight now, so enjoy. So yeah, it was a pretty amazing fight, to be honest. I really enjoyed it. Perforators is one of my favorite bosses and I really enjoy him, so I had a lot of fun fighting him. Now the thing is, I could technically already have like a magic storage, but because eventually I want to move into the dungeon and build my house over there. So I feel like, yeah, as far as I know, you have to remove the walls in order to build a bed there that works. I mean, the last time I tried it didn't work with normal walls, so might just be that. Or you have to defeat skeleton, I don't know, I didn't test it yet. But I'm gonna be trying to move into the dungeon, and that's the reason why I didn't make the magic storage as of now, since I just don't feel like it's necessary. Also, the architects, I think that's from the useful NPC mod. I don't even know if I have that one enabled right now, to be honest. I switched up my mods a little bit. I removed I'm Kisushi because they had the double spawner, and I don't want to have double spawners, that's just stupid. Plus, I just didn't, like, I didn't want to use most of the recipes anyways. So that's gone, and I replaced it with Fargo's mod, but for now I'm gonna head to the dungeon and then prepare everything in order to take on Skeleton, because I wanna show off the Abyss. So yeah, see you over there. Alright, perfect, so let's go ahead. Because I'm gonna, for the first phase with where I have to destroy his hands, I'm gonna be using the Bloodbath, because that's an amazing weapon to destroy the hands. And then after that, when it's only the head left, I'm gonna be using the Eviscerator. Because with this thing you can take away like, I think, 12,000 HP or something with Adrenaline. Since it's technically a sniper, so every shot with Adrenaline will do like 2,000 damage. I haven't tested it before, so I don't know if it actually works out like I intended to. I mean, look, I did 200 damage, so that would have been 2,000 in Adrenaline. We will see. But I feel like this is going to be the absolute Skeleton Destroyer. At least the second phase. And then after that, as soon as I get the Shadow Key, I'm just gonna leave. I don't plan to do anything else. I'm gonna, like, I will do everything, but I'm, like, my current just highest priority is finishing everything so that I can visit the Abyss. Because I want to get the Abyss weapons and I want to show off what it's like to go in there for now at least. Also, I think I could have bought a couple more potions. I mainly went with tanking potions now, but I feel like I could have bought Wrath and Rage. I don't know if that's actually a thing. This early, I mean. Whatever. I'm good to go. Skeleton is brutal, but it's not gonna be too hard, I believe. I hope at least. Also, I'm collecting these strange plants from now because that guy moved in anyways, so might as well just go for vanity. I still want to get a decent die because currently I don't. Or, like, yeah, I got the Mirage die in the failed recording, but that honestly isn't good enough. Alright, so. I mean, I might as well just prepare a second player. Also, once again, I just have to thank you for the amazing support. It's just incredible for my channel size to have around 200 likes on average. Like, the first episode had 400 something, the second 300, and the third is close to 200. So, like, everything above 150 is just insanity, and I would have never expected that, so thank you for that. So glad to see that you guys enjoy this playthrough, because I'm enjoying it as well. Like at the moment, I'm able to upload daily, that's how much I enjoy it. And hopefully we can keep that up. Also, I shouldn't go into the dungeon with a filled inventory. That's not so clever. Fuck. Because I'm gonna start deleting a couple of things that I don't need. I hate the way he's right here. Like, I'm gonna get a hit from him right after spawning him. Okay, well, never mind, I got lucky. Oh yeah, the biggest problem will be movement speeds. Plus, I don't have a mana flower, so I have to consistently drink mana potions on my own. Also, one of his hands just despawned? Seriously? Wow, great. I won the normal fight and I get this. Oh yeah, I'm retarded. I just noticed his head in death mode, as far as I know, takes full damage even if the hands are alive. I don't know why, but it seems to be this way. So yeah, I'm pretty stupid. I could have just used the adrenaline boost on him and he might have been dead already. Oh, for fuck's sake, I was so close. That's it, his hand is gone, and now it's just about using the Eviscerator. The hardest part is hitting him now. But every time I hit, I do an insane amount of damage because his weapon is amazing. I want to finish him with adrenaline. There we go. 1000, perfect. Okay, so this was easier than expected. Then again, it's skeleton, so whatever. Let's go ahead and try to get the Shadow Key as soon as possible. I want to show the of the Abyss in this episode. Also, I'm gonna take a water candle with me. And like I said, once I get the Shadow Key, I'm out of here. I don't care about anything else right now, even though I'm gonna be using different weapons from here. And like equipment. But I'm just here for the Shadow Key right now. Okay, Muramasa, that's decent. This weapon is amazing, you can literally one-shot everything in here. I love it. This weapon might be amazing for like single targets, but in the dungeon it's not the best weapon that you can have. Especially not with those insane spawn rates, like I can barely control this. Also, while I'm here I'm just gonna be taking this. Shadow Key, nice, I'm out of here, okay. Flipper Potion can also be useful, in the Abyss at least. Alright guys, you know what? It's finally time for the Abyss. I'm hyped for this, I really want to show off the Abyss. First of all, I'm gonna have to place down another chest because we will get quite a lot of loot in the Abyss. So I'm gonna have to take out some iron. Fuck, I drank a potion by accident. Alright, so let's go ahead and make... I need to make it over here, right? Yeah, chest. You should be able to place chests on tables, honestly. I don't know why it doesn't work. Whatever, I guess I'm gonna have to place platforms down. Also, I might just go to the other side, like to the other ocean, and then use a Zerg potion in order to get one of the sirens to spawn, because a siren heart might be useful. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that first, because I really need a siren's heart in order to get down into the Abyss. And then after that, we are finally going to go into the Abyss. Alright, so here I am. Let's go ahead and take the Zerg potion, and hopefully this works as intended. If not, I'm gonna have to go into the Abyss without the siren's heart. So I'm just gonna leave the screen and then go back. Oh yeah, sea urchins. New enemies that I added. Okay, I feel like I won't be able to get the siren to spawn. Box jellyfish. Oh yeah, we have a lot of new enemies now. And those are really deadly, so I should keep my distance. Yeah, we will not get the siren to spawn. Oh no. At least I can show off some of the new ocean animals, like the eel. So you can already see, the ocean has a lot of new enemies as well in the Abyss update, even though it's not the Abyss. But yeah, the spawn rate... Wait, what is that? Oh, that's two enemies and three enemies inside of each other. Yeah, okay, that looked weird. And we also got a life jelly and a cloaking gland. What can we make with those? Reduces creature detection. Oh yeah, right. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and make that because I don't fancy my chances to stay alive in the Abyss, let's be honest. So this allows us to make a potion, which makes the enemies less aggressive. So let's go and head to the Abyss. Also, if you know, like, I want to know the criteria of building a bed inside of the dungeon, because last time I tried it, it didn't work. I did it before beating Skeleton, so I don't know. I'm not sure if you need to beat Skeleton or if you need to replace all of the walls. I really don't, like, feel free to tell me because I want to have my house inside of the dungeon. But yeah, here we go. The Sulfuric Beach. First time I'm here. The water's kind of buggy because it's the first time I'm here and it just generated, I believe. It wasn't completely filled up. Usually, like there are a couple of blocks in the Abyss that generate water over time, in case the Abyss isn't completely filled up. In my case, it wasn't. So, yeah. So you can imagine it like this. The world started off with no water, but because I went ahead and... But because it took me so long to get here, the Abyss filled up itself. That's how it works, which is an amazing thing. Alright, so I'm ready. I'm just gonna go and take all of the potions. And let's go down. Holy shit, those things do much. I have the Shadow Key right here. So we are getting poisoned in the sulfuric water up there. Oh no. No? For some reason, parts of the Abyss seem to count as cave right now, which is not good. But yeah, we are down in the Abyss, this is the theme, this is what it looks like. The theme is amazing, the atmosphere is amazing. But I need to rush out, like the enemies are just as hard. Okay, first we are getting the endochoric plating, I think that's how you pronounce it, no idea. Also, I think I need to heal, honestly. Even with the potion, those enemies are insanely aggressive. I died already. Okay. I underestimated this. This is insane. Also, I believe that the Zen potion still works down there, which isn't a good thing, and I'm not gonna abuse it, because it's just retarded, honestly. I'm not sure if it still works. It worked in the last test version, and I don't think it's removed, but yeah. Alright, so we got this item, the anechoic plating. Reduces creature's ability to detect you in the abyss, reduces the defense reduction that the abyss causes. So I'm gonna equip that for the time I'm down there. I'm not gonna need a double jump in the abyss. Alright, perfect. So let's head back there. I just feel like the enemies are doing a little bit too much damage. That might be because of the death mode and because... I don't know. I think usually you shouldn't have any better armor set. I mean, you're meant to go in there after skeleton, so I feel like I'm just unlucky. Or maybe because I didn't have the anechoic plating equipped. We will see. Alright, let's take the potions again. The debuff you get down here is just fucking insane. Like, I just lost 100 HP to do the debuffs, I need to watch out. Also, this part seems to count as cave, and then this is the abyss again. It's kind of scary because I hoped it, like, I had it before that the entire abyss counted as cave and not as abyss in one of the test versions, but I hope that's fixed. I mean, it seems to work now, so whatever. This is not a good weapon for the down here, honestly. I should have brought another one. Alright, we got the hearing staff, perfect. This is what I wanted. What is damaging me? Oh, fucking fair, like, cuttlerfish are nearly invisible. Also, this lava raining down does also does damage. Oh yeah, and you can mine those in hard mode with titanium, and then you can craft life roots out of it. But you need to be plantera before you can do it. Iron boots. That's gonna be useful, but I think we will just die if I use them right now. Holy shit, look at the spawn rate. I'm literally scared to go down there. Wait, there's a chest. I need to go to the chest. Those eels are insane, holy shit. I think he's trapped? No, he isn't. Like, I haven't been down here with, like, pre-hard mode equipment yet. I've only been here with my cheating account to test. Cuttlefish. Cuttlefish, I mean. Black Andurian, this is what I wanted. This is an amazing weapon. Also, we are starting to drown, so I'm gonna head back. Because I was starting to die. Holy shit, the abyss is intense. I love it. Alright, so... Iron boots. We can craft the diving gear with all of this. This is hard mode stuff, dropped by those enemies, but after killing Plantera. So we can't use them as of now. But I'm definitely gonna be using the iron boots for down there. I mean, I might as well just replace the normal boots, since movement speed doesn't matter down there. So let's go and place this. Also, the Black Andurian, I'm gonna showcase all of the weapons after actually being down there a couple times. Because I want to try to get as much as I can. Alright, so let's buy some more potions and head down there again. Actually, I think the only potion I need is the teleportation potion, right? Yeah. Alright, let's go. Also, I should have used a different weapon. This is... I mean, I can use this weapon now, right? 50 mana potions? Okay, so because I'm gonna be using this underwater now, I'm gonna be showcasing it. Showcasing fucking voice cracks. So basically, it's a frog, and it shoots out frogs and bubbles, and it's one of the most satisfying weapons ever. And it's also really good against Slime God. This is what I'm mainly gonna be using it for. So yeah, let's go and use this weapon, because I feel like this is going to be better for the Abyss. Okay, I got all of my potions in, yeah? Do I? No, I do. Okay. Let's continue. This is intense, man. I love it. Also, iron boots equip. Yeah, you can see how far I'm going down. How fast, I mean. Okay, the iron boots, I need to get rid of them for now at least. Also, yeah, I don't have mana potions. This thing takes a lot of mana, holy shit. I actually need to watch out. We got, oh perfect, Siren Light Pet. I've shown this before in one of my videos by accident actually. Oh man, this is so fucking insane, I love it. I love this bomb so much. Yes, Archerfish, perfect. I don't know if this worm is aggressive or not, I'm not completely sure anymore, but I feel like it. And I'd rather not risk anything. Man, those cuttlerfishes are insane. You can't properly dodge them because they're so hard to tell. Yeah, okay, so I think we got most of the stuff that we can get. I don't even know, like, there are, like, at least two more drops I haven't shown. But I feel like those are more than enough. We could get the lionfish, which is a throwing weapon, but yeah, let's go ahead and show the other weapons. So first of all, we got the herring staff. The amazing thing about this is that one of the herrings only takes half a minion slot. So I right now have two minion slots, I believe, and I can summon four. And those things are really strong, like a pure summoner is amazing with this because you can take down Slime God pretty easily. Or like, I wouldn't say easy, but Rage and Adrenaline combined with those things, and when you have like 20 of those around you, that's insane, honestly, and a lot of fun. Then we get the Archerfish, which is a water gun upgrade, and it actually pierces. And this is one of the best weapons that you can use against Slime God. So I'm gonna be using a mixture of the Black Anurian and the Archerfish. Both are just amazing. But I'm mainly gonna be using this because I get threatened that I'm gonna be getting killed if I don't use it. So I really need to pay attention. I'm sadly not gonna use the herring staff at all, even though I'm the master of herrings. I'm gonna blend in a screenshot of me having like a herring army of like 400 herrings that was with a mod. A friend of mine wrote a mod for me, or like coded a mod for me that gave me 900 summon slots. And yeah, I got my game to crash by summoning 400 herrings. So yeah, I don't know, that's what I spent my free time with. Alright, so I mean, I could technically just put it all away. Deposit it all, yeah, whatever. How do those things get in here? Because of this, okay, my bad. I'm hyped, like you can hear it in my voice, once I'm hyped I'm starting to talk a lot. Which is a good thing for my playthrough. But yeah, I'm so happy that I could show it off this episode. After the horrible recording fail, showing it off now is amazing. So the thing is, you can't really go much deeper pre-hard mode, but I'm gonna be trying my best. So we will try to get down there like two more times at least, because I want to get the maximum amount of loot and show you as much as I can. So I still have those. I don't really need much more because they're gonna hit me for like, I don't know, 180 anyways. As long as I have gills and flipper potion, I'm fine. Then after that I'm gonna finish the dungeon tour and then we should be good to go to take on Queen Bee. I mean, yeah, you know, we are more than over-equipped. Alright, let's just try to go down as fast as possible without actually taking any fights because these enemies are way too strong right now. Oh no, yeah, giant squid. This is a hard mode level. Giant squids are hard mode height. Lionfish. You can see, like, yeah, this is what I meant. Also, the lava chunks do insane amount of damage. Okay, guess what? I'm not gonna go any deeper because, like, you cannot go into hard mode level with pre-hard mode equipment. Those things are just too insane. But at least we got the lionfish out of it. So the lionfish is a throwing weapon, which is just completely amazing. This is good enough to kill the slime gods. And I fear I might just use this against slime god as well. I don't know right now. It's time to get rid of some of my weapons. I have way too much of them.